Hey guys, Jim Stargazer here. Over here for the third day at the Expona audio show here at the Renaissance Center in Schaumburg, Illinois. So just making this quick intro video for you guys. So today's the third day, and I'm probably gonna have two or three videos, so I'm just gonna make one intro video for all three. So it'll be the same video like this for all three videos. So just wanna let you guys know. I saw yesterday one of the videos had a block on it. So I had to omit the sound and put some just non-copyright sounds to it. So some things like the Eagles, the group called the Eagles, their music, they just don't let nobody use it. Not even if you pay them. You have to actually do like a whole thing to pay them, and then they'll let you use it. But yeah, so sorry about that, guys. One of the speakers isn't showing the real sound. I try to leave it as best as I can. So. But yeah, guys, I'm gonna go in here. It looks like the line's not started yet. I came a little early today, so I'm gonna go up to the sixth floor. So I got sixth floor down to one, and then the convention center to hit for you guys today. And then I'll put up the videos. I still got day two to put up, and then day three. So just bear with me while I start editing these videos, guys. All right, thanks.
Okay.
Hey,
go.
Morning. How you doing today?
Doing well.
Oh, nice. Morning. Beautiful setup. Wow.
Nah,
I can take some good video in this room.
What would you like to listen to?
Something with the showcase the quality of the sound.
Everything showcases the quality of the sound.
No, there's some songs that showcase more, and some that don't. You know,
but I would just say we take pride in. It sounds silly, but I mean, I think that it's a system that I really admire, even at really low volume with really quiet music. It just sounds. Morning.
Punch it. Welcome.
Hello. You guys ready yet? You come back?
We're gonna be ready in just a minute.
To rest yourself when the silver moon is shining high above the trees. If I had stopped to listen once or twice, if I had closed my mouth and opened my eyes, if I had cooled my head and warmed my heart, I'd not be on this road to life.
Thank you. begins. He said every man's conscience is vile and depraved. You cannot depend on it to be your guide. And it's you who must keep it satisfied.
We have, yeah, those are the speakers on that. I tell you what, let me just play one.
It ain't easy to swallow.
There's no subwoofer, okay? It's just two speakers.
You said 562?
56, yeah. It's older. We have the same speakers. I wanted to hear this one.
I've come to talk 87.5
volts.
I can breathe. times we've had that conversation that, you know, we keep getting asked if we're going to make something bigger. And kind of the answer we have, you know, we got to spread out more money.
So, I mean, I
actually had a market.
Yeah, someday.
Put all in love. Understand if the other one works at the other system, perfect, you know, then you're
so
good.
That's why I wanted to try it, because I know it's dead. It's like, I wonder if it's just a randomness, because I put it in there dead quiet, they're over there, right? I'm gonna walk over there and put this down, take pictures over there. They've been doing it the whole time. They like want to take this thing home with them.
But again, I was running you know, cables across the house, for heaven's sake, and from the garage and everything.
Thank you so much.
Take care. See you again.
Bye-bye.
Follow the racetrack.
Thank you. My grandson.
Hi, how are you today?
Good. How are you doing?
Lots of fun.
Yeah, this is a cool setup. So much to show. I love this. I love this little display right here spinning.
I know. I want
like a car. You know, like a car, a brand new car.
Those are Chari loudspeakers out of Italy.
Are these Italian?
Yes.
Chari? Oh, Chario. I see. Chario. Oh, it's got a weird one.
Some part of their upper-end series is the Academy series, and that's the
sauna down here. And those are audio physics out of Germany.
Yes, our electric company.
Yeah. Last finish.
Oh, yes, we did. Yeah. We work quite closely with audio physics. Unfortunately, here we control with somebody else.
Oh yeah, Cherry Ellis's can't decide.
Where's your room? What,
just across 472.
Yeah. Thank you.
And the amp stands that you were looking at, these are by Frank, or this one, Frank Audio Accessories. And we have like this is the Fat Boy. They have the carbon inlay at the top. And then they have the slim version so you can have it for your turntables. And part of our racing theme, we have two of the fat ones in the other room in our live demo room in the Gulf Library Racing March in Toulouse.
Okay.
So really cool. You got to make sure you get a picture of
yeah,
those.
I'm going to
get
it.
Beer is a very good currency.
Yeah.
How you doing?
Take care, guys. See you again soon. So we had those made with all of our brand names put in.
I see that,
and
yeah.
And it's people are already claiming them. We have a lot of people coming at 5 o'clock to take them home.
So now I have to sort it again. I have to mess it up because then I think Rich will be upset with me if I mess up.
Well, don't put a fingerprint on it.
No.
These are B audio amplifiers and DACs in here. And along with the audio physics reference series Codex speakers.
There's something wrong with that arm.
Oh. the line. How can I ever die?
Different sound.
Yeah, that's a digital amp.
But you hear a frequency as far as this amp. Now we switch to the.
So the AdCom is still class D, right?
No, class A.
Class A.
Yeah, they never, AdCom never do class D.
Class A, full class A, or high bias class A?
Ask them. Whatever the name is. It's a different sound. Very nice, but very low, even 250 watts.
We'll be right back. someone in the other city. Maybe I'll be in love with you.
Depends much on the room.
Yeah.
If there are a lot to correct or not.
Yeah.
And then you can always see a correction percentage as well. So there are some rooms which are pretty good. Huh. So then it corrects less. That's why I said it's never, it follows a one linear approach and has that sound fingerprint of linearity to every room and every speaker. It adapts. So this speaker sounds different than the speaker next door. Right. So you shouldn't follow a linearization approach. That would mean you make all the speakers sound pretty much alike. Why do that?
Is Room Perfect available as a VST?
No, it's embedded in our amplifiers. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. In our processes for home cinema, as well as in our stereoms. However, this one here, our entry level one, that could be used as a Room Perfect processor, like an analog in out.
Oh, really?
Only so you can disable the amplifier inside. And that's 2100. So if we ignore for a moment, then someone would buy an amp,
yeah,
only to use it as a room correction device or preamp with room correction. That's also possible, but technically it's possible.
So what is the ins and outputs on that? Is that like Toslink and?
No.
We have the Doshi PhonoStage, Line Stage preamp, and the Doshi stereo amp. Two REL S510s, the KEF reference 3s, card is clear and clear beyond, wires everywhere. By day 3, I'm pretty good at it.
You would hope so. I like the dual phono arms, tone arms.
Right, and we've got a bunch of firsts happening. First time to do a direct drive since, we started in 1978, we've never done a direct drive. People ask why, and I'm like, well, encoder rings, we use a Renishaw encoder ring, which is an industrial device. It's got 350,000 lines that we can read with the read head. And then we can adjust the speed out at the fourth decimal point, fourth and fifth decimal point. The motor is a thin gap LSI 75 watt motor. And it's got multiple torque bands that we can adjust. And it's pretty incredible the technology, how far it's come from the old days when you'd get 50 to 80 samplings. And the chips were terrible compared to what we have now. So it's like, okay, now we can adjust things when with the algorithms that are being written so nobody can hear if you're doing any correction. Back in the old days, you'd hear that cogging of the direct drive. Mm-hmm. These are cordless, you know, there's zero cogging on these motors now. So that's why we decided to jump in and give it a shot.
Thank you.
How you doing?
This place feels well.
It looks pretty cool so far. This stuff. People don't realize it's not just the speakers, there's other things that actually go into it. You know, it's fabulous stuff. I even power condition all my stuff. Alright guys, we just finished up with the hotel room. We're gonna go ahead to the convention center now. We'll go check out the big listening rooms. So yeah, let's start heading down there and see what we can find. I thought you guys might want to see the hallways outside of the hotel rooms where things are at. So Trade and B2B Meeting Lounge. Oh, okay, it looks like it's a crossover. I want to go down. I know there's some more rooms at the downstairs, so yeah, let's pick up back down there. Yeah, I just wanted to film this real quick, guys. I know a couple of people commented on the Florida one that they don't offer food or anything, but here they have multiple places. Few different restaurants, a few different vendors set up, even got beer out here. So yeah, the Florida Audio Show, they had like sandwiches, but wasn't like this. This one had like an entire restaurant over here. All right, let's head down and try to find these rooms. Hey, came down the escalator and we got the setup right here. Clear audio signature. I see Macintosh over here. Macintosh and Sonus Saver. Awesome equipment, guys. Look at this. We got a 1.25,000 watt amp. Couple of those, couple tube amps. Okay. Hey, looks like we got some Bowers and Wilkins over here. Let's go see if we can find Bowers and Wilkins. I'm surprised Mark Logan didn't get a big room like this. Yep. Bowers and Wilkins. Probably Mark Logan didn't build this big rooms.
Cool.
No, like, look at stuff up. It's, like, he's super fun
to listen to. I want to try
that on my system.
When love
is king.
He's like weird, like, crazy, like...
I remember, when love...
With his fist unfurled.
Getting over to the speaker if you hear. Beautiful Martin Logan. I mean, Bowers. Bowers 800 diamond. Oh, they got their sub too.
Oh, hungry children. First, he'd think to pull their lives from the brink. When love was king, he rescued souls lost in the sea. In drifting vessels, he would hear their plea. When love was king, he threw a line before they'd sink and gave the thirsty ones a drink. Told the meek that they should try to use the sword to smite the lie. That being kind is for the weak. When love was king, I pray the Lord, these words we seek. Whoa.
All right, guys, looks like that's it. Looks like that's the end of the show for me. I did all the rooms. I tried to do all the rooms for you guys. I did all the convention rooms. Yeah, so this is day three, end of day three. So this is going to be at least three videos, guys. So I'm just going to use this same ending a video for all three videos, so I don't have to make another one. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching the videos. Don't forget to check out the rest. I'll put the links above, like I said, in the other videos, and check out some other videos I got coming up. I got I'm going to doing some speaker power sale coming up this week, and they're going to be shipping me an amplifier to do unboxing. I'm going to put it into the power bottle. But yeah, guys, thanks for watching the video.